In this video, I'm going to pick up where Kathy Scott left off with her PubMed search. I replicated her original search strategy, obesity prevention and control, and applied some limits, although these may be slightly different than what she applied to her search. What I want to do is I want to go through these search results and find things that I may want to refer to, either cite or read later during my research process. So I'm going to go through and mark a few. So I've marked 4 items in the list. And the next step is I want to get these out of PubMed and put them in the RefWorks. So the way you do that is you have to save it as a text file. So I'm going to send to the citation manager. And the way it does that is it generates a text file that RefWorks can then parse and import. So I've marked 4 records, so it's going to save those 4 records when I click the create file. So you choose where you want to save it. Choose it to my desktop. You can put it wherever is normal for you. And you're going to get this text file. Now in Chrome, I've already told my text editor how to read that file. So when I click it, it just opens it up. Now you don't need to do this. But I like to do this just so I can see what's going on. So you can see that even though it's a text file, it's a highly formatted thing. Each field corresponds to some item that came out of the database. So you can see that 25 is the volume number. Here's the issue number, spring 2015. Title. Down here we have the author's names. We have a bunch of mesh subject headings, publication types, journal name, and then you repeat that all over again with the next one. So vital signs is the name of it. You've got a nice big long abstract, page numbers, author names, name of the journal, et cetera, et cetera. If you can go through the list, you see that each item in the list that I marked will be represented in this text file. So now I've got this text file saved to my desktop. I want to import it into RefWorks. You do that by references import. Pretty straightforward. You need to go through a number of steps once you do this, though. So you want to check your filter data source to match NLM PubMed. Now it's showing up for me because I used it in a previous video. But if you don't have it selected, you can go down here and choose NLM PubMed as your source. Once you've chosen your source, then you'll have to choose your database. Now, PubMed is pretty much the only option because it's NLM PubMed, but some of the sources may have other options, so just keep that in mind. You may have to choose which database you're bringing it in from. Third step, find the file that you want to import. And those are the 3 required steps. Encoding, you don't really need to worry about. Latin 1 is fine encoding. I sometimes like to put things into a folder. You can either create one on the fly or choose an existing folder that you've already created. So I've had this adolescent obesity folder that I made previously. So I'm going to put them in there because that matches what my search strategy in PubMed was, right? So now we're ready to go. Click import. If you're successful, it'll say import completed, and then the number of references that it was able to parse and import will be represented here. View your last imported folder, and now you're going to see the same 4 references that you marked are now represented in your database. I like to go through each one. You can either do that by parsing it in the standard view, taking a look at it in, say, maybe American Medical Association style. And just take a look at the citations and make sure they look cool. Now, one thing I did notice up here in the standard view, though, is there's this first one. It's a little weird. It's got Center for Disease Control and Prevention, listed as one of the authors. If I go back to my original text file, you see that the reason that happened, see, I find it now, there it is, vital signs, is because Center for Disease Control and Prevention was listed with the authors. CN stands for corporate name. It means it's an author that is a corporate body. I probably don't want that listed though among my authors. That's sort of a glitch in how this thing came in. So I should probably edit that. There's two ways to do that. You can click the little edit button, or if you're viewing it in full mode, you can edit it down here. And all I'm going to do is go to the author field and remove that reference. So here's Center for Disease Control and Prevention. Just select that. Save the reference. If there are any other changes I need to make, you can go ahead and do that. But I think I'm pretty much done. I look at it, looks much better now. So that's pretty much it. So the steps are, do your search, set your limits, mark any references that look like you want to import them, you send to Citation Manager and save your file. Once you've saved your file, import it by setting the source, the database, and the file, and optionally import it into a folder. And that's pretty much it.